So here's one of the models that is in the curriculum models of the NetLogo models library. So if you go to file models library and you go to curricular models, there's a number of different curriculum, evolution, chemistry, gas, particles, material design, probability, et cetera, et cetera. I was actually involved in some of the evolutionary work, so I'm going to go down to bug hunt camouflage, which is one of my personal favorite ones and the one I brought up. And this one, what we've done is this is a tool that's meant to teach how evolution works, right? And so we have these agents over here, which are the different bugs. And what we're going to have is we're going to have children kind of go through and click on the ones that they can see. And what that's going to do is select over time for ones that camouflage themselves well against this background. And you're going to see that show up. So we can hit go. When we hit go, our cursor changes to a hawk, right? And we can start to click on the different bugs that we can see. And over time, you'll notice they start to favor certain hues, start to favor certain colors that blend in a little bit better, either reds or greens in this particular landscape, right? And I'm actually running out of ones I can even see right now. You can actually hit the flash button to kind of make them show up. And you saw there's a red one up there that's hard to see, for instance. This one's pretty easy to see, so we can get rid of some of these, right? But even those ones are starting to blend in pretty well, right? And this helps to teach, using the basic principles of agent-based modeling, how evolution actually works, right? That we have these selective pressures to kind of evolve animals to develop mechanisms that allow them to avoid detection, right? So that's one example of how NetLogo is being used and agent-based modeling is being used to teach children to this day. So here I have one of the models from the gas lab curriculum. This is one of my favorite ones. It was actually being developed while I was at the Center for Connected Learning, working on the NetLogo development team. And you can see, by the way, if you're ever interested, there's a bunch of comments and developments as to how this work comes about. But in this particular case, right, we have two different gases separated by a wall, and they're in two different boxes. And we can kind of look at what their average speeds are and what their average energies are. And because the speeds and the energies are separated from each other, because they're not interacting with each other, right, they don't have that any effect on each other, and they're kind of fairly constant over time. But what we can do, right, is open the box and allow the two different gases to actually mix. And what you see is that because this magenta gas has such a smaller mass compared to the cyan gas, all of a sudden its average speed and its energy goes way up, while the cyan properties actually come down in order to meet those, because we have to get to a mixture that's in the middle eventually, right? And we can close this gas off and allow it to stabilize again, the box off, and each of the chambers will stabilize separately, and then we can open them back up and so forth, right? Allows you to experiment and understand. So we're using agent-based models in this context to actually simulate the actual particles moving around in this world, right? And to explore how their energies and how their velocities affect each other in a way that helps students better understand things like gas movement and motion.